Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Dear brothers and sisters in Islam, Ramadan is around the corner. This year we will pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that this Ramadan be an awakening to renew our faith and connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gathered all of his companions into the Masjid of Medina and gave them the good news of the coming of Ramadan. They were still in Sha'ban and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam yet mentioned Ramadan has come with all its blessings. Every good deed will be rewarded in many manifold. The doors of the Jannah will be opened and the doors of the Hellfire will be closed. And the shaitans will be chained. And there is a night which is better than 1,000 months of a reckoning. And if someone is betrayed of this blessing, he is really betrayed of the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allama Ibn Rajab al-Hanbali, one of the commentator of Quran and Hadith, and an excellent jurist, commented on this hadith saying that this is the fundamental basis of greeting of the coming of Ramadan al-Mubarak, when the believers will greet one another saying Ramadan Kareem, wishing the coming of Ramadan. This hadith is regarded to be the basis of that kind of opinion according to Ibn Rajab al-Hanbali rahmatullahi alayhi. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to purify us. Purification has to be from the heart, through the body, and through our limbs and actions. Because Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to say that fasting is not mere abstinence from food and drink. It also the abstinence from the sins and the things that are prohibited by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. مَنْ لَمْ يَدْعَ قَوْلَ الزُّورِ وَالْعَمَلَ بِهِ فَلَيْسَ لِلَّهِ حَاجَةٌ مِنْ أَنْ يَدْعَ طَعَامَهُ وَشَرَابًا. If anyone is not ready to abandon telling lies and acting upon them, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has no need of him leaving food and drink behind. So brothers and sisters in Islam, this Ramadan we are to reform ourselves. يَوْمَ لَا يَنْفَعُ مَالٌ وَلَا بَنُونَ إِلَّا مَنْ أَتَى اللَّهَ بِقَلْبٍ سَلِيمٍ. The best ever preparation we could do for Ramadan is to cleansing our hearts from any evil thoughts that might be a hinder between us connecting with our Lord Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Holy Quran, يَوْمَ لَا يَنْفَعُ مَالٌ وَلَا بَنُونَ. On the day of judgment, neither wealth nor children, nothing would be of benefit for us. إِلَّا مَنْ أَتَى اللَّهَ بِقَلْبٍ سَلِيمٍ. Except those who have approached Allah with a clean heart. So first of all, beginning the race towards Ramadan, our main aim has to be to clean our heart, to cleanse it and fill it with piety and consciousness of Allah and taqwa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Getting another Ramadan in our life is as if we are given an addition of 84 years into our life. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, commenting on the life of the believers of this ummah, he said, أَعْمَارُ أُمَّتِي مَا بَيْنَ سِتِّينَ وَسَبْعِينَ. The age limit of my ummah is between 60 to 70. Yet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala provided for us a chance in every year, in every Ramadan, to get an addition of 84 years if we are to meet with the Laylatul Qadr, the night of power, the night of decree, which is equal to or even better than 1,000 months. 1,000 months is equal to 84 years in our life. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sincerely that He may guide us and give us tawfiq to fulfill our duties towards this guest who is round the corner and to get all the blessings of the night of decree, insha'Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Getting another Ramadan in our life is another blessing and another addition in the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let me just relate to you one of the hadith reported by Abu Huraira radiyallahu ta'ala an and Talha ibn Ubaidillah radiyallahu ta'ala an. Two of the companions of the Prophet who embraced Islam from the tribe of Bali, which is belonging to Qudaa'ah, and both of them declared their Shahada, and one of them attended a battle and martyred. The second, who stayed for another year, then he passed away after his friend's death by 1 year. Sahabi Talha ibn Ubaidillah radiyallahu anhu, he's one of the 10 who were given the glad tidings of entering Jannah, one of the Asharatul Mubashareen. He mentions that I had a dream, and a dream of believers definitely will have meanings. So Talha radiyallahu ta'ala anhu says he was right in front of the Jannah, and someone came out of Jannah, it would be an angel, and called the one who died later than his friend who martyred, and asked him to enter Jannah. And I was wondering, two of the friends, both of them embraced Islam at the same day, on the same time, and one of them martyred. And we know the martyrdom, shahada, is deserving greater reward with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yet the martyr wasn't called to enter Jannah first, but it was his brother, his friend, who lived for another 1 year. So I was just wondering, what's the matter? Then after a while, an angel came out of the Jannah and asked the one who martyred to enter Jannah. Then I was there, and he told me, Talha, you're not yet to enter. You are still living on earth, so you can go back. Waking up from his sleep, Talha ibn Ubaidillah radiyallahu ta'ala an mentioned this dream that he saw, which is a little bit strange, that normally we expect a martyr should enter Jannah first before anybody else. So he told this story, this dream, to many of his companions before he was about to meet Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam in the morning. And everyone who listened to this story were amazed and shocked to learned that the martyr was delayed from entering Jannah than his friend who lived for one more year and died thereafter a normal death. To clarify this, he approached Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Then the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam gave him this amazing answer. Didn't he live one more year after his friend in again martyrdom? Didn't he fast in a Ramadan after him? And didn't he pray more than 6,000 rak'ah of fard prayer and many of sunnah prayer after his friend died? So this means the distance between him and his friend is much larger than or farther than the distance between the earth and the sky. So what we understand from this hadith is that getting another Ramadan in our life is addition of lot many rewards and ibadah into our life. So this is the time to begin the race. We begin the race by appreciating the virtues that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala given us in this blessed month, by reciting Quran, reflecting on its meanings, understanding the meaning that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has hidden within the verses of Quran, reading it profoundly, and giving charity and sadaqah, and competing in goodness and keeping away from sins. And once again, I want to reaffirm that Ramadan is not the time to leave our bad deeds and get into good deeds. Rather, Ramadan is the time where we continue to be good and increase our goodness in this Ramadan. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us His abundance blessings, and He may save all of us and all the believers from His wrath and in His hellfire. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala admit all of us into His mercy and into His rahmah and paradise. Ameen ya Rabbal Alameen. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.